A 13-period calendar, also called a P13 calendar, uses 13 periods instead of 12 months and simplifies many consistency-related aspects of planning, particularly in the retail, hospitality, and consumer goods industries where planners need to better compare workweek and weekend data using calendars that don't vary from year to year. For example, retailers using a traditional 12-month calendar can't accurately evaluate an increased volume of sales on Saturdays and Sundays, particularly over a holiday season, because the number of months in the calendar varies. Using a 13-period calendar resolves this issue. Because a 13-period calendar ensures the same number of weekends in comparable periods, your calendar is more consistent. It helps optimize forecasting and analysis throughout your enterprise, from inventory and sales management to labor planning and profitability analysis. You can ensure holidays occur in the same week and period each year, easily assess key data across years, such as profit and loss statements reflecting 28 days of sale and an equal 28 days of payroll, and more quickly spot trends, since every period has the same number of weekdays and weekends. We provide a flexible 13-period calendar definition for new applications in these offerings: EPM Standard Cloud Planning, EPM Enterprise Cloud Planning, and Enterprise Planning and Budgeting Cloud. The P13 calendar definition you specify when you create an application applies to all modules and works with a rolling forecast. The calendar logic drives all date-based calculations in the modules and can be used with custom plan types. Each period is exactly 4 weeks long, except every 5 or 6 years when one period has 5 weeks. By default, the first 3 quarters have 3 periods and the last quarter has 4. Set up your calendar definition by specifying the years that the application will span, distributing periods across quarters, indicating which quarter has 4 periods, specifying exactly when the fiscal year ends, and identifying which period should have 5 weeks. To easily differentiate between periods, you can enter intuitive prefixes. You can preview the calendar dates for each period by year using the Application Overview Actions menu. After creating your application using a 13-period calendar, configure your planning and forecasting granularity for each year, leveraging the flexible definitions and timeframes for 13-period and weekly setups. For example, you can plan at a weekly level in the Financials module, choosing to plan for 13, 26, or 52 weeks. Weekly values convert to monthly values. The 53rd week occurs every 4 to 5 years and is added to the period that you specified in Add Extra Week to Fiscal Period when you created your application. If you use a rolling forecast, select the basis and frequency for your continuous planning. The number of actual periods defines how many time periods of actual data you want to display in forms and dashboards, along with rolling forecast time periods. Your calendar and granularity settings are reflected in all relevant forms, dashboards, and all date-based calculations integrate 13-period logic. End users will notice the period dimension has 13 members instead of 12, and P13 members are added to year total. In workforce, if payment terms are monthly, periods 1 to 13 are the payment methods, and calculations assume that component expenses occur in the period with the last day of the month. For example, if payment frequency is one-time pay, expenses calculated for the selected period, not month. Or, if payment terms is annual, calendar year, payment frequency is one-time pay, and one-time pay options is set to first month, the expense is paid in the period with January 31st. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.